Very good evening, everyone. Today, for the Lucky Show Mentor Talk, we have a very super special guest with us, a multifaceted woman and a well-renowned and well-acclaimed as firebrand journalist. It's Nana Srinivasan Iyer with us. So, Namaste Ji. Very good evening.
Such a pleasure.
All right. Yeah, for the audience over here, like, you know, like who are across India, like, you know, who doesn't know like much about your profile. Most of the people know you as a writer and editor, and the other set of the segment of people know you as an activist, and other set of people know you as an environmental and animal and like lover. And what else, like, I can't even describe you in such a words. So it's better you introduce yourself with whatever, you know, you want people to know about you.
Oh, I'm just a simple person, actually. I could be any of you.
My God.
But that, we all have to discover whatever is in within us, you know. And then when you see the facets within you, then life unfolds itself in various ways. Like I used to be a sports person, so I began my career as a sports journalist. So from being a sports journalist, I moved on to write features and then write, you know, what interested me most was human interest stories. And entertainment. So I went on to become an entertainment journalist. And then I started building brands. It was a passion. So I built brands of UTV, Sahara. I have been a part of these and spearheaded them. And spearheaded them as well. So that is my journey. But from childhood, we loved animals. So because we loved animals, when we brought home a dog, when we brought home a dog, the dog was very for there with us for 3 days. So once it was there with us for 3 days, I didn't have the heart to let it go. So I did some rona dhona and I didn't eat food. And my parents just keep it. So Jimmy stayed with us for 22 years. So I don't know how old she was when she came to us, but she stayed with us for 22 years. And between that, one dog followed her home, and we had another dog called TP. Mm-hmm. And one after another, I think right now we have about 21 dogs at home plus about 85 cats. So that's it. We just open our doors, they come in. Sometimes you don't have to open the door, they come in through the window. But you see, it's their home. So it's sort of become a home now. People come, they call, they come, they drop. It's funny that I've never gone anywhere to pick up an animal on my own. They have always come. So when you have it in your then whoever needs you finds a way. So we also...
So I can say a third home which is open doors 24 hours, isn't it?
Yes, yes.
All
right. Right now we are running like too overfull. Because if you have too many dogs, then they start fighting among themselves. It's because we are like at peace, so the dogs are at peace, you know. Apart from that, we also run a shelter in Virar and support one in Mud Island. We set it up for them. So that's what we've done. So we take care of that over there. Now, apart from the shelters that I am talking about, I also work for the environment. So I run a foundation called Make Earth Green Again Mega Foundation.
Mega. All right.
Yeah. Through Mega, we work for environment, we work for people, we work for assets. We work for anything that is Earth and its inhabitants.
Yes. So, when you mentioned, like, I would like to ask you a question. Like, how did this happen? Like, from the moment, you know, the initiative which you started for acid attackers, the rehabilitation for acid attackers. How did this happen?
Actually, one of our friends, he works with acid victims, and he has done a book on them. He's basically shot them. His name is Shirish Shete, the former head of PTI. So when he came out with his thoughts and he shared the way acid victims had a problem and how it's like you're neither dead nor alive. It's a very difficult situation. Nobody wants to look at you. Nobody wants to work with you. Your own family doesn't recognize you. Your children don't recognize you. You go through so much physical pain and endurance that you have to go through so many multiple surgeries. That I felt the need to extend my hand and help them out. But it's only a small effective compared to what we are doing for the tribals during Corona, because for acid victims, we haven't still reached the space where we can do much more. The idea is to stop the inflow of acid. No
Okay.
acid victims. The problem is it's very easily available in the country. Even though there are laws and there are protection, there are ways in which people procure them. So
All right.
that is something also, there should be a rehabilitation for them. The day we succeed in those kind of things, then we are truly successful. The tribals,
Exactly.
we've been helping for the last 5 to 7 months, ever since this COVID set in. I have a shelter, I told you, which we
Oh,
support.
yeah.
So I think that
Okay.
the lady who works in the shelter is also having a financial crisis. And everybody in the village has financial crisis. So then I found out
Right.
there are like 8 Adivasi padas, and all of them are hungry because nobody has work. And during lockdown, everything was locked down.
Okay.
So that's why I decided to give them ration. I work with other organizations on this, and we give ration to the tribals. Apart from that, we are planning to set up a Balwadi for them, and also a Adichi Pathshala, where the old people will learn to make their signatures, you know. So when you
All right.
start having signatures instead of thumb impressions, it changes your outlook towards life. And the first thing
Definitely.
that a grandmother would do is start educating her grandchild. So it's a step in the right direction that we are planning. This is something that we do with the Adivasis. Why do I do all of this? I think it's all because of my mother. She taught us in our childhood to help anyone who comes. Matlab, I don't remember, I've got strangers home. They've stayed in my house for months. We don't even know them. I've just met them somewhere, you know, maybe at a job interview or maybe at somebody's place. But I have met them, and then suddenly they are home, and the next thing I know is they are living in my place, they are having khana. So it's like that. My relatives have come home, they've stayed in my house for months. So I think
Okay.
that upbringing, my dad never had an objection. He was an amazing person. You ask him for one dress, he'll get you 30. Never mind, 20 didn't fit. But everybody in my building used to wear the dress then. So if I ask for a black dress, then I have like everybody in my building wearing, because different people have different sizes. So we've never had this thing, you know. It didn't matter how much money we made, whether we didn't have money. It never mattered. What mattered was the thing to give. So that came to
Right.
us automatically, to both me and my brother. And we're all like that in the family. I think my kids are also like that only. You open the
All
door,
right.
anyone comes, everybody's happy.
So the whole inspiration came from your mother.
Absolutely.
All right. So how do you inspire your children? Like, how are they now? What do they do in your services?
Actually, I don't think it's even my inspiration. I think it's blood. My children are
All right.
exactly like that. My younger boy used to bring dogs home. Meet Hari and meet Suresh. Now you have to convince to get Hari back to their mother because he's named them on the way home. We go to the beach, Sandy is coming home with us. So it is a very
Okay.
natural thing. My elder boy is like, you know, he connects with the animals so much, the animals connect back with him. Like if there is a, you know, there's a cage in which there are like 15 mice kids and there's one mother mice. Even if you go near, the mice will bite. He puts his hand inside, he picks up the kid, he sets it up, the mother doesn't touch him.
Okay.
So he has
Wow.
that connect with animals that, you know, more than what I actually do.
Okay, that's so nice actually. All right, so you being a writer and director, like you have been, made films for like different causes. So where did this start from?
Actually, I wrote Crime Patrol, and I've been a journalist, so I wrote crime because my friend was doing Crime Patrol. He needed to write and set it up, so I called
All right.
Hussain Zaidi, my friend, and he did his first show. He set that show up, and he's written a lot of books. So then, and then I wrote that show. So when
Okay.
I wrote the show, I met this. I needed an assistant to write other projects. So one of the guys was a director. Matlab, he was very good at what he did. So I told him, what are you doing assisting me? You should go and direct. What are you doing? Doing something so small. I mean, you were like there. So
Okay.
he much. And then he had a look at my script and everything. And then he said, I want to meet you one day. So I met him on near Cinevista's office downstairs. And he told me, you should direct. So I said, why? But I've never thought of direction. He said, no, because when you write, I can see your film.
All right.
So
So the
that
narration
motivated
style.
Yeah, so I thought, okay, why not? So then it struck me, and this film happened by chance. And at the time, my child was so small, I wanted to make the film, and then banana, banana, Kim banana, banana. And then my younger boy grew up, my elder boy grew up, and my younger boy grew up to be 12. And I met a couple of my friends, same director, another girl, and we were just chatting, and I was saying, "Arey yaar, picture banana." I said, "Banao." So he said, "Theek hai, chalo banate hain." So in 3 days, we made the film. One day, pick up my kid, बनियान, एंड टोल्ड हिम इसको गंदा करो, बनियान दो, चलो शूट करना है. सो ही केम आउट टू शूट विद द ट्रस्ट दैट एन एक्टर हैज इन अ डायरेक्टर इज ऑल दैट इट टेक्स फॉर यू टू मेक अ गुड फिल्म. द
एग्जैक्टली,
फिल्म
वेरी
द फिल्म इज टोटल अमेचर्स. नोबडी इज अ प्रोफेशनल, नोबडी इज एन एक्टर.
राइट.
सो
एंड मोर ओवर,
वी
लाइक यू नो, आई गॉट टू नो दैट यू नो, लाइक दिस पर्टिकुलर फिल्म व्हिच यू मेड ऑन, आई मीन व्हाट यू कॉल, चाइल्ड लेबर, इफ आई एम नॉट रॉन्ग, लाइक आई बिलीव द नेम. सो दैट पर्टिकुलर फिल्म ने, लाइक व्हेन इट गॉट लाइक अप्रिसिएशंस फ्रॉम ने, लाइक 101 इंटरनेशनल, नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल फिल्म फेस्टिवल्स. How did you feel that? Like, what kind of a confidence it gave you, being a director?
See, when I went to Cannes, na, that was my best motivation. Okay. The audience at the festival is called Entrée to Marché Cannes. It's a festival only handicapped people attend. Okay. It's a festival for handicapped. The child in the film is a mute. He can't speak. So the film went to the handicapped festival. We had blind people watching, we had deaf people watching it, we had people with multiple handicaps who couldn't walk, who had a lot of problems watching it. And they made it simultaneously for different people, different methods. We were called thrice on stage. And all 3 times, he spoke so highly to us. We had audiences hug us, tell us how we worked for equality of everyone. You know, the best part, the audience spoke French. The host spoke French. The festival people spoke. So nobody understood the language. They understood the language of cinema of a Indian child laborer who works in a tea stall and has his dreams, and how in the end he helps another handicapped. So it was a very simple one line. It was not something where, you know, we did not know about sets, elaborate sets. We didn't make a, you know, I don't know, huge thing. We made a very simple, short, 5 minutes, 21-second film, but it touched people. So that was the most important
the
thing.
Connect what the character gives. That makes a sense.
Yeah, always have been that person who understands people, who likes to talk to people, who touches people with their words. So that went into the cinema and realized that that's all that it takes to make a film. It takes a heart.
Great, great. So, can you let me know, like, something about the Zindagi helpline which you are behind with? What exactly is that and how does it work?
Okay, Zindagi Helpline is a very simple initiative. I realized when I was working with the San Hospital that people have a thing called copycat syndrome. So when you see somebody who even motivates and the media plays it up, then you feel the want to die because he died. So similarly, what happens is, suppose a woman died with, say, a 14-year-old kid or a 4-year-old kid in a particular manner. Maybe she jumped with an infant from the terrace. You see, we all tend to do these things. There is postpartum depression, a lot of stuff that leads to it. Yeah? You could be clinically depressed or you could have situations you want to escape. But it's her situation, right? It's not that everybody's going through it. So the media puts up the whole thing. They put up, kaisa aya, kahan pe gaya, kitne baje kahan gaya, kaise kiya. They even draw sketches.
Media puts up also, sometimes.
So a lot of them feel inspired by it. And because they feel inspired, they go ahead and do the same thing. So in order to make a, you know, be there to hold a hand, because they do people want to commit suicide, always express red flag syndromes. Red flag syndromes are when they tell you things like, I'm tired of my life. I want to put an end to my life. They talk about death. They talk about
private things.
To be alive in very different manner, which we don't register at all because we are too busy with our own things. Maybe Facebook, maybe Twitter, maybe Instagram, or maybe watching a funny
one book, tag, you know, one hashtag is fine, one comment is fine. That's what we do.
Correct. And but we do not pay attention to the people around. So this red flag syndrome very big difference. So in order to have someone who talks to you at any point that you feel suicidal, I made a Zindagi helpline. So people call at
Okay.
any time. They call at 3 o'clock in the night, they call at 2 o'clock in the night, they call when they are sad. But we've helped them. It is basically,
Okay.
I've initiated it. I have a lot of people in it. I have psychologists, I have psychiatrists, I have sexologists, I have
Right.
counselors, and I have coaches. So what happens
Okay.
is, whenever a problem, if I am not able to at some point handle it, they take care of it. And also
Okay.
people come on a WhatsApp group that we have. So they pick up the person they are comfortable with and start talking to them. So then we share it in between ourselves, and then we advise on kya karna chahiye. So it works. And once it's about tidying that moment when you feel suicidal, okay. And then you have the same feeling after a while, and then you tell them after a point that I'm there with you always. But you are your own protector. You have to find your own ways. And also, a lot of times these are because in our own mind, na, we are not assessing a situation right. Maybe I am just so rude to the person that he is rude to me. Maybe I just don't like him. So it is not a one-sided problem. It's always a two-sided problem. So what we
All
do
right.
is we try and tell them on how to actually react to this situation. So when that keeps happening, then everything sorts itself. Then everything sorts itself. Then we sort of
Love.
make him comfortable for the person.
Okay. So, as of now, I know, like, you know, like, you have even launched this Zindagi Helpline and Mega Foundation and Mumbai. So, is it available as a pan-India movement? Is it available in other states?
It's actually, it's also there in, I think we have people from Johannesburg, we have people from US. Our social
All right.
media is handled by a girl from Canada, and everybody is a volunteer. So
Okay.
everybody has come in. It's available to anyone. You just have to go type Zindagi Helpline, come on the page and ask. So it works. And my number is available anywhere. Just come on my,
Okay.
or come on my Facebook and tell me I want to be in Zindagi Helpline. I'll add you on the group. The more the
All right.
merrier.
Great, great, great. So, because you're like, there was, I know a certain group of people, say doctors, psychologists, psychiatrists, life coaches, counselors, and they're like volunteers as well. They're like, who wanted to connect with, like-minded people where they can reach up their services to more people, right? For the
They
needy
can,
people, like, there isn't no.
yes, they can always connect here,
So,
and there we can always connect to them anytime.
all right, all right. Okay, through this show, like, everyone would come to know, like, how they can reach up to Anusha here, of
Yes,
course.
thanks.
Because, there are a few people, who we want to connect, but we doesn't know how to connect with them. And will it be possible to connect with them? So this show will be an answer for those people, how to easily, connect with such kind of a people and expand their hands to serve the needy people. And, I mean, how did this happen? TEDx, what is TEDx first of all?
Oh,
There
that's
are
a
so many
very.
TEDx speakers. There are so many TEDx speakers, we come across. But what exactly TEDx? It's the very first
Okay.
day, and I'm putting this question.
See, TEDx is a platform in which you reach millions, okay? It's a
All right.
respected platform. I have seen TEDx speeches, but I had not known, I mean, TEDx is TEDx, okay? I just, another speech, you watch so many of them and it's inspiring. So the platform really was not my key. And I was talking to two of my friends where they were, one of them told the other that, "Are, she's got a zoo at home." So the other guy said, "Are, itna animal kyun rakha hai?" So I said, "Bhai, tune bahar nikala to maine rakha hai." So he told me, "But you're doing such a noble deed." So I said, "The noble deed is like that. Yeah, I'm not actually doing anything. They empower me. They actually teach me to forgive and forget. They teach me to be a
Wow.
good person. You know, they teach me that life is about being happy, eating, sleeping, shitting, and going back to sleep again. What is the fourth we look for? We don't have a fourth
That's
dimension.
wonderful. That's wonderful.
They teach us to live. So the more I have, and how grateful can you be for your existence? We are forever complaining as human beings, you know. And how
Exactly.
grateful they are that one bit of life we gave them, never mind the guy who tortured them. Somebody must have beaten the dog, broken its teeth, broken its ribs. It must have come home broken, but it doesn't break its spirit. So that
Exactly.
spirit is what needs to keep us alive, and we should be grateful for everything we've got, not for the moments lost, but for the moments gained. You know, and they teach us a very important thing, Krish. They teach us that Everybody comes into your life for a season or a reason. If
Right,
they came,
right.
went, came, season. If they took you somewhere else, reason. And nothing in life is ever permanent, including life. So if we
Exactly.
get it right, then we don't feel tortured by small things. You just let go. The problem is never there around you. It always existed. The problem is always here. The moment you learn to let go, then it's okay.
Right.
It is not easy. But the moment you let go, you are letting yourself go of that huge burden you are carrying, and you are giving that burden to the other person. You let go of that person also. And then the next step that you no blood pressure, no diabetes, no headache. You already have a whole
Influence
series of.
yourself.
You are just adding on. That adding on goes away. And dogs and cats and all animals per se teach you minimalistic living.
Right.
Existence is about minimalistic living, no? And when we make
Exactly.
our towards it, someday everything falls in place, you know?
All right. So,
That's.
living a life with principles, with no expectations, is what like animals do, and we supposed to
Yes.
learn from them. Actually, we say that humans have got like six wishes. Our brains work too much than the animals, but still, for cultures and life, obviously we supposed to live them, learn from them, and adopt their living. So no, nothing bad will gonna happen to us. And we can have a peaceful and happy life, of course. That's a wonderful message
Totally.
you have shared with us. So all the audience who are watching here will definitely try to do a little bit at least. Not though as big as you. At least a little bit, we'll try to do that. So what are the future plans do you have? In terms of environmental activism, what are the things you're planning to do in the future, 2021?
See, we want to plant as many trees as possible.
Okay.
You give back to Mother Earth what you got from her. If you don't do that, then
Definitely.
you don't have an to live in. It's a very simple give and take relationship. Mother doesn't expect. That doesn't mean children have to be, treating
Bring
her
back.
like that. So first is to plant trees. As many trees, maybe 5 lakh trees in Maharashtra to begin with, and then go nationwide. The second thing that I have in mind is we are doing these seed bombs. Okay? Bombs made with seed. So you give it to children and they throw it during the rainy season, it brings trees. There's a 50%
Yes.
success rate on it, okay? So, but 50% success rate is still a lot of rate. And also, we're looking at, what do you call them? Drones, by which we drop these seeds before rainy season on mountains, so the whole mountain becomes green.
All
God
right,
bless the rain.
that's fantastic.
And that's one. And then the other thing that we're doing is we're planning to tie up with a lot of organizations. We have already tied up with quite a few, where even when we fed tribes for the last so many months of COVID, we had a lot of other people who joined hands, individuals, organizations. We know them, so they join us. So it's
All
like
right.
there, and even if you know them, people like you connect us to somebody and to somebody, and
Definitely,
then
definitely.
we don't do it for branding. We only do the branding on our social media pages to make other people understand. There we just go, we hug people, and we're happy. That's about all. So the rest of them can always have their branding. It is not a problem at all. My branding only happens on our pages so that people know we are involved. So that
Yeah,
is something
exactly.
that.
This is one issue I always have with the so-called NGOs, the branded NGOs, who claim to say that they do all the services, they reach money to the end, they reach to the needy on the time, everything. But they come up with branding, the advertisements or the televisions or social media, wherever, pulling in celebrities and promoting their services. I always have a question. Why do you want to invest such a big money on advertising yourself on social media or television, wherever, which you take it from somebody as a donation as for a cause? So this I always have a question, but when I've gone through your profile, I have never seen such a kind of unwanted expenses towards promotion. But you reach up to all the poor and needy people. You reach up to the environment, you reach up to the animals, and whatever you do, you do it for a cause without most of publicizing. but people come to you. So this is why, like, I wanted to know why, how people can reach you. Because there are so many people, good-hearted people, like-minded, who are waiting for people who can lead us. For example, you know, I can tell you, like, you know, like, just, you know, like, a month back, when my son's, on my son's birthday, you know, we were supposed to celebrate it. So celebrating the birthday, like, he asked me, like, you know, to support children on the streets. He's just 8 years old. He created a thought in my mind. In each and every birthday, instead of, like, cutting the cakes and, like, inviting him, like, letters, he told me that there are so many children on the street who always, you know, like, look at me when I eat something. So that day I decided, okay, fine. From this birthday onwards, every birthday, at least 200 children on the street, you serve. And just last month, you know, he asked me, like, Papa, like, we're going to do something quite new. It was my birthday, May 22nd. He asked me, like, better get me some plants which I can gift it to my friends. So we purchased, like, 100 saplings. I gave him. He was not convinced. He said, at least, you know, 1,000. I asked him, like, you don't have 1,000 friends. Why do you want to buy 1,000? He said, like, isn't everyone on the roads I supposed to give? It's your birthday. I'm going to celebrate. I'm going to celebrate this way. So we went ahead to, I mean, a nearby nursery where, you know, like, whether it is my good time or not, I don't know. They had, like, 700 saplings by the time. We purchased the whole thing, everything we purchased. And he made me, like, wait, and, like, the vehicle was there. Each and everyone who pass on, whether the walkers, the bikes, two-wheelers, four-wheelers, whoever comes by, he stopped them on the road, he gave them everyone, all the saplings. And nowadays, like, I didn't know, like, you know, this will become a big thing, but I shared a few pictures on social media, on my Facebook, that my son has done this. He initiated a movement today. This activity made 100 people to reach up to me saying that they also want to do the same thing on their children's birthday. So this is where I thought, okay, fine. A small activity can even inspire so many people and, you know, bring together. But to channelize this, you know, one time I do, next time whether I be able to do or not, I'm not very sure. But people like you who have a very big, you know, organization, who do it for a longer time, when people connect with you, you know, their things will be channelized. So this is the main reason why I, you know, like, rush up behind, you know, such kind of people, and I bring them on screen and I make them, you know, reach to everybody, each and everywhere, look at corners. If people come to know, there are some platforms where they can reach up to. For example, you know, when you started, you know, Zindagi Helpline, it was quite new. And now there are a few other organizations also who work on, you know, like, giving counseling and other stuff. But when you started, it was quite new. And how did people receive it?
Actually, it was, it multiplied by itself. Okay. Suddenly people started coming and I left an open link. I put it in few groups. Uh-huh. Few groups put it in more groups. And then it was like the same thing. We have more than 268 members who are there to help others.
All
they're
right.
Not even there for help, huh? They're there to help others. And everybody okay. connects to everybody. Strangers connect to me on Facebook. Tell me, please help this lady. Call her right uh-huh. now. She's feeling so bad. So you find so many people who are coming to you from various facets wanting to help others. That's the most beautiful right. part of having a movement like this. And we are also empaneled with the Sinta now. So any actor uh-huh. or anybody who's a, you know, is in trouble in the film front, they can always call us and we will take care of their problems. Because it's a very fragile right. industry, no? You're like a fire.
Exactly.
So today you're very beautiful and tomorrow morning, you know, your life is one day. So it becomes very difficult for them to handle that. Psychologically and financially both.
Yeah, so and moreover, like, these kind of issues are more often, more common in this film property industry. No fashion
yeah,
and
because
media industry.
Like, हम लोग गलती करते तो छुप जाता है एंड एक्टर करता है तो छप जाता है. सो दैट बिकम्स अ वेरी
एग्जैक्ट
बिग थिंग नो, इट बिकम वेरी डिफिकल्ट फॉर देम. ओके, व्हाट्स योर सन्स नेम?
दिनेश दिनेश कृष्णा
प्लीज टेल दिनेश कृष्णा टू कनेक्ट विथ मी. आई फर्स्ट वांट टू
डेफिनेटली
ऑनर हिम फॉर मी एंड
ओह
देन
थैंक
आईड
यू सो
लाइक
मच
बी
थैंक यू सो मच
एम्बेसडर ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन बिकॉज इट्स द चिल्ड्रन हु मेक इट बिग.
इट्स माय प्लेजर थैंक यू सो मच थैंक यू सो
It
मच
will be so nice
एंड
to
लाइक यू नो
connect with you.
एज यू सेड यू नो ही इज सो मच यू लाइक कनेक्टेड विद पेट्स एनिमल्स which you know I don't do actually but he's so close to like animals he love like pets you know in my house like he has got his aquarium he has got his own aquarium now it's been just like every month you know he takes you know like pocket money used to buy like 5-10 fishes he put it across and moreover like you know he used to feed all the street dogs not one he'll live I don't like you know have a dog in my house Because my mom is too much allergic towards you know, dogs, so I am unable to like, you know, breed a dog in my house. But my son does it.
Happy. He can feed any dog as long as he's happy. You can't bring everyone home, no. But it's okay.
Exactly. So
His own
wherever
thing.
he walks, you know, like on the roads, wherever he finds, he immediately go to a nearby shop. He purchases some like biscuits, feed everyone. He come back and you know call me back. Papa, I have you know purchased these many packet of you know biscuits today. Better pay the shopkeeper. He'll not
There's
even you
one
know wait for money.
more thing you can do. Whenever you
Okay.
travel by car anywhere, you can have glucose biscuits and old Bisleri bottles for water. Children in the
Okay.
signals need water. So if you just give
Definitely.
them old Bisleri bottles with water that you fill from home and glucose biscuits, you may have actually fed a child for the first time during the day.
All right. That's a sort of good thing, but you're like actually I don't want. I mean, personally, I don't you know entertain that. So sorry to say that. You know, if I entertain such a good children, like with a child, giving her like money or some kind of other stuffs, it actually you know it entertains them, not to come back.
One bottle of Bisleri and one glucose biscuit will only feed. It will not entertain anybody to do anything. I'll give you an example.
No.
I was thinking like
Okay.
you only, and I was writing Crime Petrol. So when I had gone to write Crime Petrol, and this friend of mine, whom I told you, told me that I can direct, he met me. I had come down and waited. So when I was waiting for him, you know, you see everything around you is bored. So I bought some plastic stuff for 200-300 rupees that I don't really need because I am waiting. And one kid came and asked me for money to eat. So I gave him gyan that kuch kaam karo, ye tumhara umar naya hai, school jao, all kinds of everything intelligent I could say as a well-read Indian. I did. I went to eat. I sat with my friend. We had food. We spoke. And I don't throw away food. Okay, that's something that I can't leave food in the plate also. That's the way we've been brought up. So I took the dal that was remaining and I went out to give it to someone. This child was sitting with mother who had an infant in her hand. I gave the dal. It's just a gesture of giving a bowl of dal. The child pulled it from my hand before his mother could take it, opened that dal ka dabba through the dhakkan and ate itna sa dal that was there. He has not eaten for days. You know, and here I was giving him gyan, buying rubbish that I don't want. I didn't, you know, I was just too stunned. I couldn't talk. I didn't think of getting anything to eat for that child. I did not say anything. I just walked off from there and came home. But even today, when I see that child in front of me. Because what I normally do is I go in a railway station, I find this kid thandi mein aise kaam par hai, ask him, "Tere ko kya khane ka hai?" They always tell you, "Mere ko cake khane ka hai." And then you buy them vada pav, you buy them chai, and you give them cake. And you tell them, "Ye bhi kha." But that's how it works. Because we don't know what others are going through, yeah. We don't know. I
All
mean,
right.
as I meet these little children, I sit with them, I have lunch with them, I have dinner with them. I make it a policy that whenever I make any money, I find a street kid and I give him a treat. Diwali we go out, made one kid into literally one chota bappida. I took him out, I got him dress, I got him shoes, I got him cap. His name was Saddam. I am a Hindu. We celebrated Christmas. And then in the last shop where I bought him clothes, He actually asked for the bathroom and there washed his face, his neck and everything. And he's telling me, "Kal se nahaunga." It's a big thing for the child. And when I feed these children, and what happens after that, I'll tell you. It's like when you first feed them, they all come and pull things from you. Okay, that's the way they are because nobody's been giving them. And then I tell
राइट
them, "Don't do that." देखो दे रहा है ना तो खींच क्यों रहा है. सो एंड देन आई टेल देम तेरे को फिट ही नहीं होएगा क्यों ले रहा है. सो दे रियलाइज आफ्टर अ पॉइंट दैट शी गिव्स. सो व्हेन एवर यू गिव देम समथिंग दे विल टेल मी. वन बॉय टेल्स मी, मेरी माँ ने ना ब्लैक कलर का स्वेटर मांगा दीदी जो आपके हाथ में है ना ऐसे ही. सो टेल ऐसे ही स्वेटर मांगा. सो इट वॉज लाइक दैट. अदर वन से ये मेरा साइज का नहीं है इसको देना. नाउ आई हैव पीपल हु कम एंड टेल मी, वो आती है ना उसका बेटे को 103 बुखार है, आप प्लीज कुछ दवाई लेके दो. So I buy them. First, I used to buy medicines. I used to repeat and give them. Because if you don't open, then sell it. So now when I repeat, they tell me, अरे मत खोलो ना दीदी, भरोसा रखो हमारे पे. And they actually have won your trust. Because they don't use it for this themselves. They give it to other children. Somebody has fever, you help them. Somebody has a घाव, you help them. They come to you and ask you for it. And I buy them tissues. They ask me, मेरे को आधा किलो चावल लेके दो. Now you could have asked me for anything, right? But why only आधा किलो चावल? Quantity has also become right. The people have
Right.
become right. So it is the way you do. And somebody who come without chappal, where the hell is your chappal? He'll say, chappal nahi hai mere paas. Next day you buy him chappal, third day you go and see if he's wearing it. Otherwise, you give him one tapli and make him wear the chappal again. It's not a one-night thing that you give something to them, it works. People steal from them. I give it to grandmothers on the street. Okay. Now, grandmothers who have come from their villages in Tamil Nadu sleep on the streets here, beg and send money home. I bought them all new bed sheets, okay? Because they sleep with plastic cover on them. You know, they tie the bed sheets to plastic and hang it up on the tree. They use a boy to climb up and hang on the tree because when they sleep, people steal their bed sheets and so imagine the situation 80-year-old woman must be going through. So once you start helping them and empowering them, they tell you, मेरा 7 नंबर का जूता इसका 8 नंबर का जूता. You see that confidence and the way they can actually ask somebody for help. Little children sleeping on the street, you can give him one sweater, wake him up, put a sweater on him, okay? उसको मालूम ही नहीं है वो उठा है. He's waking up in his sleep. You're making him wear a sweater, you're making him wear a pant, you give him a chadar, सो जा. Child's going to sleep. Morning, he will think Santa Claus came. You have a guy sleeping on the street with literally nothing on him, you put a bed sheet on him, and that guy puts that bed sheet on himself as if उसका ही था. And we have rickshaw wallahs. People, women on the street, they come to you, they tell you, ये भी है, इसको दो. So that art of giving, ना, comes when you start
It
sharing.
develops.
हाँ, it is automatic. So the pain and the anguish these children go through is unimaginable because the father is either a drunkard or died, mother is either a prostitute or mother is washing vessels. So nobody really has the time for him. So how do you help them? And how do you help a child when he is being molested, sexually abused on the streets? He has nobody to tell. The molester will be
Definitely.
in his house. How do you help them when you tell them? I'll tell you the most beautiful experience of my life. I normally go for one tapri chai at 2 o'clock or something. So, and I had a dog whose leg was broken and she used to do hangama. So we used to take her out, get her ice cream, and at 2 o'clock get her boost. So then she would come back and sleep. I went at 2 o'clock outside. And these children are all sitting next to the चाय की टपरी. से 2 दिन से आपके लिए बैठा है सर, क्या हुआ? दे हैड ब्रॉट मैंगोस फॉर मी, दे हैड ब्रोकन फ्रॉम द ट्री.
ओह
सो द
राइट
थॉट वाज दैट आई सेड तेरे लिए रख इसे, अरे मेरे लिए बहुत है, ये आपको देने का था. एंड आई टोल्ड हिम, हाथ में कैसे लेगा बिकॉज इट्स गॉट दैट थिंग ना, द मैंगो बंच योर हैंड. दे पिक्ड अप अ पेपर फ्रॉम द स्ट्रीट, पुट द मैंगो एंड गिव इट टू दी. नाउ माय फ्रेंड्स टोल्ड मी, अरे वो देखना रास्ते से उठाया, आई सेड उसको उतना ही समझ आता है, घर पे जाके धो लेंगे. आई टोल्ड देम ऑल थैंक यू. We did a selfie. I have shot 1,000 selfies with them. The cutest
ओके
part is they can't see the selfie the second time, but they want to shoot a selfie every time. You give them a coke, they want us to shoot video, so they sing for it. So it is that little moments of happiness that you share with the children. It really makes their life. Maybe going through something so bad
True,
that,
true.
and I have this thing, people reach out by default. When grandmother will look into my window, knock at the window and say, "Ek chadar leke aaoge kya? Idhar agla bar aayega to." So it's like that. I don't even know her, no. But I'd find the
Right.
chadar and I will find her and I will give it to her. So it is like that. It's a cycle. When you start building, na, then it works for you. Like how animals come to my house. It's not like I advertise. I'm not even registered. Yeah, I'm just registering my organization now. After opening my
Okay.
sanctuary, after opening a second one, after opening a third. Then I did. Because right now we are working for tribals. stuff like that, where we need to talk to the ground. So we need to be right. We did
Right.
Dabbawala scale. It was small thought. The Dabbawalas, I was working with Mukti Foundation and Smita Thakre. They were helping the Dabbawala. So I did a
Okay.
story on it and helped them out so we can help more people. So when I did that, I realized that there are more than 3,500 Dabbawalas. We've only helped 100. So I put it up on my Facebook. I connected with the Dabbawalas, the details. And then I had the Guardian Minister of Maharashtra call me from this Guardian Minister of State call me through a friend asking, "Acha, kya chahiye, bol?" I know him, but he's not my buddy, right? So he told
ओके
me, ये हो जाएगा, कभी करने का पता. Done. We gave food. We gave ration to them. See the energy
वाह
that comes through the giving. Now I will come to the advertising part, which you don't like. Explain to you. I come from PR. Why I don't put it out is because I don't want to put it out. I don't like putting out stuff which is like that. Like my animal organization, I have been running now, what, 31 years, 32 years. We've been doing probably more, but we've never done it because it's all from my personal funds. So never felt the
right.
need to make noise. But a lot of times, what happens is like a poor child has picked up a cat. He always wanted a Persian cat. I'm giving an example. Went to the shop, looked at the cat every day, but he can't afford it. Finally, there is one dying cat. This is a real life experience. Okay, the dying cat. So the guy gives it to him and says, "इसको बचा सकते तो बचा ले, इधर मर जाएगा." So the child brings that cat with great happiness, but the cat cannot live without medical or food. Recovery food is very expensive. So when they call up and they say, "मेरे पास एक बिल्ली है, मैं आपको लाके दिखा हूँ, यू नो द कैट इज हाफ डेड." So you bring a vet on board, you connect the child to the vet, you tell the kid to the vet that इसके पास जाने का, ये तेरे को सब दवाई देगा. और खाना क्या चाहिए? द वेट विल टेल यू, ये खिलाओ ये खिलाओ ये खिलाओ. सो आई पुट व्हाट्सएप एंड आई सेंड इट टू 5-7 फ्रेंड्स. द लास्ट टाइम जैकी श्रॉफ, ही सेंट द डॉग फूड, ही सेंट द कैट फूड फॉर द कैट. नाउ सी, जैकी कुड हैव जस्ट ऑर्डर्ड अमेजोन, जैकी कुड हैव जस्ट सेंट मी मनी एंड सेड दे देना, बट ही डिडंट. ही मेड हिज ड्राइवर टेक ऑल द डिटेल्स, बाय दैट फूड, ब्रिंग इट रेगुलरली टिल द कैट रिकवर्ड एंड गिव इट एट होम. सी, एवरीवन
ओके
वांट्स टू लिटिल बिट. Somewhere the world is alive only because of a few good people.
ऑब्वियसली
So important
नो
to
डाउट
reach out people, that medium helps. I am not talking about wearing Banarasi saris and talking in 5-star hotels. No, I am talking about reaching out. If we weren't doing this Facebook, we probably wouldn't connect. We probably wouldn't understand each other.
वेरी
I
ट्रू
probably wouldn't know
ट्रू
that your son is an awesome guy. So are you, but I like your son more.
ट्रू थैंक
That's the space.
यू
So that is what we can do when we reach out. The more we reach out, the more people join us and the more we can help. And I like
Sure,
that
sure.
part of the thing.
Exactly. See, like, I know, person to person, the what do you call it? The field differs. The way we
Absolutely.
look into things, it differs. In such a way, like when I travel, social activities. Of course, I do like various activities. In terms of COVID, when it started, initially I was able to provide. I didn't know that it's gonna be for a longer time. No, we thought that it's going to be a short time, so let us support, let us help out people. Every day, I started with providing 1,000 food packets. My mama said, Beta, don't do this much. It will be for longer time. Like, do it with your pocket limit. I said, no, mama, if I'm doing it, it should be bigger. So I all the way, came after 20 years to my neighbor. So people are watching me, what I'm, so let me do it. People want to know that I come back with enough of money, to support so many people. So let me do it. So I cooked I procured the raw materials myself, cooked myself, packed it, took it in the vehicle every day. For 68 days, I was able to do. I'm so thankful to God that 68 days was blessed to me. Financially, I was able to do that. Every day, 1,000 packet of meals and buttermilk, 200 liters every day. And the herbal drink, Kapasura drink was there. So, which was very much advised by Siddha doctors as a cure for COVID. So, every day 200 liters. So, this was served every day. But, too many, I know, there were almost 6 to 7, guys in my area who volunteered with me, in packing the foods and in bringing it, disposing everything to the people. So, it happened for 68 days. But 69th day, there was a very big, a call came to me from my accountant, stating that, sir, we have fallen short. This much, we couldn't pay the salary for 11 people now. So that day I felt, okay, fine. So God has given me 68 days, and rest of the days, I should shut myself and sit. So from there, I started online. Prior to this COVID times, I never spend my time on social media. I never know that social media is such a powerful medium to connect with people or share good things and all. Sitting at home, nowhere I couldn't go. I didn't have money to continue the services. I want to do something productive, use my time. Came ahead. Well, discussing with a friend of mine, she said, why don't we talking good thoughts every day? So every day, 10 minutes, we used to share the good thoughts. There it started, and now I reached you actually. So now, so many good people nowadays, they support us. They come forward. They connect with us to spread positivity. So this is what, through this show, I want to do. Spreading positivity is what I think more important for this current situation, because COVID has become a very big teacher for us. Then mothers taught us, then father taught us, then the teachers taught us. COVID taught us a very good lesson, how to live a peaceful life without a big expectation, without luxury, we can live. People earlier doesn't know that, without luxury they can live, but COVID made them, live. So this kind of situation, pandemic situation, at least, once in a year, it should come. I expect. So that people will be living
Wrong
a
way.
realistic life. People will be realistic, I should say. No, not in a dreamy thing, not all luxury and rich
Not
things.
happening, huh? You can have a retro film running once a year, but not the pandemic. It's made so many people, but you're right. Ultimately, it's taught us to come back to our roots.
Right. So this kind of things, is more important, I think.
Somebody asked me whether you will buy this saree or this jewelry. I tell them very politely, "Ab pehnega kidhar?" By default, everything is sorted.
All right. So, thank you very much for joining with us and spreading all the positivity through sharing your experiences. And I'm very sure whatever happens is let it happen. But think, one thing will be very sure: there'll be people connecting with you towards Zindagi Helpline, and of course for Mega Foundation. There are so many activists who are running bay and serving the nature. So nature lovers are there. So they'll be connecting with you. So with your support, it can reach up to many people. And apart from this, I would like to ask you only one question. What will be your next film?
I have actually four films in mind, okay?
Okay.
And one of them is called Mehak. What would a mother, when she has a choice of choosing between motherhood and motherland?
Okay.
It's the choice of a
Fantastic.
woman that she makes. So that's my next, and after that I will be doing the other scripts.
Okay. Because I'm a filmmaker, so I'm more connected to your films. So I keep watching your films. So
Thank
I'm
you.
just eagerly waiting for your next product to come out. So thank you so much for this wonderful time you have been shared. Thank you very much. And a
Thank you
few
so
words from
much.
you for the audience.
It's a very important thing, It's not necessary that all of us has the time, energy, resources, or the inclination to help others. It's not necessary. If you're not helping someone, you're not bringing home a dog, you're not bringing home an orphan child. Or for that matter, even if you don't celebrate your birthday with an orphan kid, it's okay. No problem. The only thing that you must remember when something is going wrong, stand up. It is very, very important. If a rape happens in Kathua, you have to stand up. That is our nation's
Right.
motto. We will not sit and make, generic statements about what is happening, what is what. If something wrong is happening, the government is not responsible for it. You and me as a society are first responsible for it. We
Responsible,
can build
yes.
I would only request Krish, like how all of us are, within each of us is a little lamp, light the
Right.
lamp and use that flame to light the next, and the next flame will
Definitely.
light the next. We are
Pass it
in the
on.
era of marketing. Let us be in the era of MLM positivity. Let us light
Yes.
lamps. Let us light ourselves. Let us light the other people who are with us. Let us bring light into this world. Once we do something
Sure.
like this, corona का बाप भी हमको हाथ नहीं लगा सकता. We
जी.
have to be right. You know, the more wrong you do, the more wrong comes. The mirror, life
Exactly.
is a mirror. We have to start being good. We have to start being positive. We have to start doing the right things. We have to stop committing atrocities on others who are weaker than us. We must start
100%.
being the voice of the voiceless as people and stand up against anything that is wrong. And
Exactly,
then the world
exactly.
will be changed. You know, you may not be able to do it according to your resources. Like day 68, it was out, man. I understand. 2 months I paid salaries to my kids, and 2 months later I ended up karna kya hai mujhe. But the kids said, we are with you. And suddenly I
Yes.
was more strong. And instead of looking at myself, I started looking at the savings I had. I broke everything and I started feeding tribals. Now work is back. We are happy. There was never a void. It is just this. ठीक है ना, ऊपर जा रहे तो नीचे आएंगे,
Right.
नीचे आ रहे तो ऊपर. I mean, God has taught us, yeah, one hemisphere has darkness, the other hemisphere has light. But it's only one
Right.
circle away, right? That's it.
Huh.
Sometimes the circle is a little long, or क्या? It has also taught us very interestingly, Krish, to unravel facets of ourselves we've never known before.
Very true, very true. It brings
To
out.
work on that. Maybe we were destined to be someone else and we were just running a race we were not meant to run in the first place. Look back at life, relook at
Exactly.
life, and be happy. A key purpose, a goal in life, mein, happiness. If you are not happy, you're in the wrong place, brother.
Right.
No amount of money is going to help you. No amount of fame is going to help you. No amount of jewelry, no bungalow will help you. When a child sleeps in that triangle in the middle of the road and says, Didi, मेरे को तो बहुत मजा आता है. मेरे बेडरूम से मेरे को स्टार्स दिखता है. तो आई थिंक मेरे बेडरूम से मुझे स्टार नहीं दिखता है भाई, तू स्टार है. दैट्स
Fantastic.
द पर्पस ऑफ लाइफ. लाई डाउन इन द बेडरूम, लुक
Right.
एट द स्टार. यू कांट सी द स्टार्स, यू आर एट फॉल्ट ब्रदर.
Right.
सो दैट्स इट. एंड यू नो, आई जस्ट एंड विद दिस वन लाइन व्हिच आई यू नो हर्ड फ्रॉम द स्वामी जी फ्रॉम इस्कॉन. ही टोल्ड मी
Okay.
दैट एवरीथिंग दिस वर्ल्ड इज हंग्री, not for food, for love. So spread it. And he who has nothing and is content, he has everything. So if we just go by those two lines, I think we've reached where we had to reach. Nothing else we need.
Definitely. No doubt. No doubt at all. Thank you so much, ma'am. We'll be connecting with you so soon. And we need to spread this particular positivity and the spirit everywhere, across the nation. And if possible, we'll explore to the world as well. Thank you so much.
Thank you, and I want to meet your son.
Yeah. Sure. Very sure.